there's lots of myths behind mistletoe. It grows on oak trees, it's a parasite, and these myths are related to the ability of mistletoe to be living in the wintertime. So on oak trees, when all the leaves turn brown and fall off, that's when people really start to notice these big clumps of mistletoe. And being green and alive during these cold winter periods is a sign of, you know, strength, fertility. Holly trees, which you often see around Christmas time also for decorations, are another tree. They're an evergreen tree. So they also have these myths. Mistletoe is a hemiparasite. So it's a type of symbiosis where it takes but doesn't give anything back. In this case, the mistletoe is stealing water and nutrients from the tree, but can still make its own sugars because it has a green color. So it can still do photosynthesis and make sugars for itself, but it does steal water and nutrients from the tree. These are the flowers. So it's now in bloom. And these will form berries. Yeah, so this is Phoradendron leucarpum, or American mistletoe. The Phoradendron stands for tree thief. The leucarpum stands for white fruit. So it will get these kind of white berry looking things on it.
Now, will it kill a tree?
Typically, mistletoe won't be the reason for the death of a tree. You know, it would probably be something because the tree's already weak in some other way or stressed out by something else. Because it is a parasite, they typically don't want to kill their host, right? Because if the host dies, then they die along with it. It's a native plant. The trees are native, so it's like that, going back to the will it kill it, you know, they've had a lot of time to work these relationships out, so they are adapted to one another. And as far as the benefits, you know, the benefits typically do outweigh any kind of downside, I guess, to the tree, because it is beneficial to wildlife.